Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. This is Anirudh. So in the second video for Prism, we'll just continue from where we have left. Now we'll be beginning with the topic of prism under white light. Okay, prism under white light. So let's suppose that white light or sunlight is actually given into a prism. Fine. So there will be deviation for the prism inside the prism of the white light. Now, white light is made up of VIBGYOR colors. Seven colors are present as such in the white light, right? And the deviation, if you just talk about that, this deviation will be different for different colors. Fine. Why? Because for each of the colors, actually the wavelength is different as well as their frequency is different. So the refractive index for each of them will be different as a result of that. Now, due to that particular reason, the deviation which is exhibited by each of these colors is different. So you have fed the prism with the white light, and as it comes out of the other side, each of these colors are going to have separate deviation. So one will be deviating to some angle, the other will be deviating to another angle, the other will be deviating to the other angle. So that means all these seven colors, since they are showing multiple deviation, they will be splitting from the white light. And this kind of a splitting is called by the name of dispersion. Fine. And why is dispersion happening? Because the deviation is different for different colors. Now, if I'm denoting deviation by delta, this is the minimum. See, it is the least in case of the red color, isn't it? Red. Since the refractive index for red is least. Fine. So since this is the least value, I can say that the deviation for the red color is the minimum. Okay. And delta is maximum, that means deviation is maximum for the violet color. See, I am taking the red color, this is this extreme, and this color, that is that extreme. Now, mu of violet is maximum. Fine. So as I go from this side to that side, my wavelength is decreasing and my frequency is increasing. Also, I can say if both these things are present, the refractive index of each of these is actually decreasing. Okay, that is why the red refractive index is the least, therefore the deviation of red is less, while deviation of violet is the maximum. Fine. So let's proceed to the topic of dispersion now. Okay, it is the phenomenon by which white light splits into its seven component colors . So yes, I have formally defined the topic of dispersion, the definition for dispersion, and that is phenomenon by which white light is actually splitting into its seven component colors, violet, indigo, blue, green, yellow, orange and red, right? How will I get this happen? This is because of the fact that the refractive index of each of these colors is different. So as they pass through the prism, they will show different deviation. So each of them are deviated to different angles. That is why as it comes out of the prism, you will get each individual color separately. Fine. So let's proceed into further details of this. So now, as you can see in this particular image, I have a right angled prism as such here, and this is my incident light. Okay, incident light is supposed to go here, and as it comes out, it comes as splitting into seven different colors. So I'm just taking the extreme colors to be representing over here. Okay, so this is the violet color. It has the maximum deviation, so it maximally deviates to this particular side. So this is violet. Now, red has the least deviation, so it is almost towards the normal direction, right? And what is lying inside this, we will be taking this as the median color, okay? What is lying inside, like in between all these things? Something in between this, something in between violet and red. So if you just talk about this, it can be either green or yellow. We will be taking yellow over here. So yellow is somewhere in between red and violet. So that is almost in between these two things, right? So this is just a representation of three important colors in this particular spectrum, and I have just represented that. It took me a lot of time. That is why, just to draw this, as I was saying in my previous video, I'm not an artist I don't have these kind of artistic skills to do this on spot, but it took me a while to do this, and that is why I just cut the video over there and just continuing now. The point is, see, delta is equal to mu minus 1 into A, right? This is our equation. So now we will talk about delta mean. Okay, so that is delta mean. That means which is lying inside, it is median. Okay, so we just between the red and violet. These are the two extreme cases. Which is lying in between, this is yellow. So this is the refractive index for yellow minus of 1 multiplied by A. So this is an important understanding that we can understand so far as our this deviation is concerned. So whenever we are using the word deviation, it simply means that it is actually the minimum deviation. That means mean in deviation. Mean means that it is actually the yellow. I am talking about the yellow as such, because yellow is actually lying in between red and violet. So that is why this is an important equation that you can just remember. So whenever I am just saying delta mean, it means that it is the deviation for yellow color. Why? Because it is lying between the red and violet color. Right. Now if I am just extrapolating this particular red over here, and I am extrapolating our violet also like this. See, if violet is actually, so this diagram, it's very difficult for me to do that. So if violet is actually coming like this, I am just extrapolating violet in this way, okay, and extrapolating the red also in this way. Right? So this is how the incident ray comes. And that splits into the red and violet. Okay, red and violet, it splits. So if I'm just extrapolating both these things to the back side, then I see that all the seven colors are coming from a cone. So I am just looking at this from this particular angle. Okay, so if I am keeping my eyes over here, I see that seven colors are actually coming from a cone. And this angle of the cone, which is, I think it is a solid angle, this is called as the angular dispersion. Fine. So what is angular dispersion? That is the next question that we are supposed to know. Fine. So this angular dispersion is actually defined as the angle of the cone from which the seven colors appears to come. Okay, so the seven colors are actually coming as the incident light. If this is the incident light, if this is the incident light, it as such, whenever it is having a deviation, because of the difference in the deviation, all these colors are splitted. Now, if I am looking through this kind of a view, I am seeing that all these colors are actually coming from this particular point. Now, if there are seven colors actually coming over here like this, then all these things will together form a cone like this. So this will be forming a cone. Now this particular angle of the cone that I see, that apparently I am seeing as I am looking from this particular angle, is called by the name of theta, or the angular dispersion. Okay, it is the angle of the cone from which the seven colors appears to come. It is not a real angle, but it is a sensation that I am actually feeling when I am looking from this particular angle to see how the light is coming through the prism. Fine. Now we are supposed to understand the angular dispersion formula. So this is given by the difference of the deviation of violet minus deviation of red. Okay, delta V minus of delta R. Fine. So theta is equal to, this is the difference between deviation of violet minus of deviation of red. So this theta is equal to mu V, that is the diffractive index for violet, minus of 1 multiplied by A plus of mu red minus of 1 multiplied by A. So this you will be getting it as the theta is equal to mu V minus of mu R multiplied by A if you solve this. Fine. So these are the two equations you can remember for the angular dispersion. Fine. Okay. The next thing is about a concept called as dispersive power. And it is denoted by omega. Fine. So this omega is equal to, what is omega? Omega is equal to angular dispersion, that is theta, divided by mean deviation. Fine. So this is called as dispersive power. Dispersive power is equal to angular dispersion divided by mean deviation. Now substituting the values for angular dispersion, that is actually mu v minus of mu r multiplied by a, and mean deviation is the deviation for yellow light, that is mu y minus of 1 multiplied by a. Fine, so you will get this as omega is equal to mu v minus of mu r divided by mu y minus of 1. Okay, so this is an equation that you're supposed to learn. Now what is the unit? See, if you just think about the unit of these two quantities, angular dispersion and mean deviation, you will see that both their units are equal. Why they are equal? Angular dispersion is equal to the subtraction of two deviation, isn't it? Deviation of violet minus deviation of red. Mean deviation is the deviation for yellow. That simply means that both of them are having the same units. So dividing two quantities which have the same units, that is why we can say, simply say that this is unitless and dimensionless. So omega is a unitless quantity and dimensionless quantity, right? So thus we have learned all the important concepts in regard to the deviation concept, and we are now going to the combination of prisms as such. Now remember, a single prism, we have learned two concepts over here. One is dispersion and the other one is deviation. For dispersion, we have just learned all these kind of concepts now. Angular dispersion, now dispersive power, etc, etc. And for deviation, we have had a previous big discussion for all the conditions. Minimum deviation, maximum deviation, small prism, etc, etc, etc. Were there. So now that simply means that a single prism can have two effects. One is dispersion as well as deviation. Now, I want that kind of a condition where I specifically want dispersion without deviation. Or I want deviation and I should abolish the dispersion. So whenever you want any of them, any one of them, I just want dispersion and I don't want deviation. Or I want deviation, I don't want dispersion. In these kind of situations, we will have to combine two prisms. So we are actually going to the concept of combinations of prisms. Okay, why do you want this? Because a single prism has two properties, dispersion, deviation. I just want only one of them. And I have to abolish the other. Fine. So for combination of the prism, whenever you are combining a prism, one single prism will have a delta, that means deviation. The other prism will also show a delta, that is another deviation. So the net delta, so the total delta net is equal to total deviation that is created by two prisms is equal to sum of the individual deviations. So that is mu minus of 1 into A plus of mu dash, that is the second prism, minus 1 multiplied by a dash. Fine. So this is the first prism deviation, second prism deviation. Add them to get the net deviation for the new prism. Now, theta net, that is dispersive angular dispersion theta. Okay, that is mu r minus of mu v. Okay, multiplied by, I mean, this is mu v minus of mu r, isn't it? It's been a long time since I have revised these concepts. That is why I'm just confusing these things over here. Mu v minus of mu r multiplied by a plus of mu v dash minus of mu r dash. This is for the second prism multiplied by a dash. Okay. So the combination of prisms. So the net deviation for combination of two prisms is equal to sum of their individual deviations. Net angular dispersion for combination of two prisms is equal to sum of the angular dispersions of each of them. Okay. Now we'll go into the two concepts now. So my first concept is dispersion without deviation. So I am combining the prism so that I will get a net dispersion, but I don't want deviation. I have to abolish the concept called as deviation from this particular prism. Fine. Now, when dispersion is present, okay, when dispersion is present without deviation, it simply means that the net deviation is equal to zero. So delta net is equal to zero while dispersion will be present. Okay. Fine. So what is the net delta deviation? That is mu minus of 1 into A plus of mu minus of 1 into A. This is the second prism, so I am just denoting this is equal to that. is equal to 0. Fine. So from here I need to understand what is a dash. So a dash is equal to minus of mu minus of 1 multiplied by a divided by the mu dash minus of 1. Okay, so this a dash, that means the second prism is having a negative value. What am I actually finding here? I am finding the angle of prism for the second prism. So angle of prism of the second prism is shown to have a negative sign here. Why is it so? I am getting a negative sign for angle of prism because my second prism is inverted. So if this is my first prism, I will have to keep my second prism in such a way that the second prism is inverted. So this angle of prism is over here, while a dash is over to the other side. That is why I am getting a negative sign over here. Fine. Okay guys, now let's talk about the net deviation, theta net, okay, in dispersion without deviation. So this is the dispersion component of that. So this is equal to mu v minus of mu r multiplied by a plus of mu v dash minus of mu r dash multiplied by a dash. Fine. For a dash, I have another equation. So we have just found out the equation for a dash in the previous equation. So we'll just substitute this value over here. So this is equal to mu v minus of mu r, it's a bit long calculation, you can do that, plus of mu v dash minus of mu r dash multiplied by a dash. So what is a dash here? Minus of actually mu r, okay, mu minus 1 divided by mu dash minus 1. Okay. Now you see over here, this mu minus 1 by mu dash minus 1, that is the, mean deviation. So this is for the yellow light, isn't it? Yellow light. And there is a negative sign over here. So I am just substituting negative sign in place of this particular positive sign. Now, if you solve this, it requires a bit of calculation. I do agree with that. If you do that, theta net is equal to theta multiplied by 1 minus of omega dash by omega. So what I have done here is that I have just compared it with the equation for the dispersive power. And this is the condition for dispersion without deviation. Fine. Now, the same concept can be done for deviation without dispersion. Okay. So that is my second concept. So this time I want only deviation to happen, okay, and dispersion should be abolished. So theta net is equal to 0. This is the dispersive power, I mean angular dispersion, this is equal to 0. This simply means that a dash is equal to minus of mu v minus of mu r multiplied by a divided by mu v dash minus of mu r dash. Just by the previous way I have just solved this. See, how did I get this? I have substituted the net equation, that is mu v minus of mu r into a plus mu v dash minus of mu r dash multiplied by a is equal to 0. So for that matter, what is a dash here? A dash is equal to this value. Now, I need deviation, isn't it? So delta net is equal to, what is delta net as such here? Delta net is equal to mu y minus of 1. I'm just taking the mean deviation as such. Mu y minus 1 into a plus of mu y dash minus of 1 multiplied by a dash. So in place of a dash, I will be substituting this particular value. So that simply means mu y minus of 1 multiplied by a plus of mu y minus of 1 multiplied by minus of mu v minus of mu r multiplied by a divided by mu v dash minus of mu r dash. And if you solve this, I will say delta net is equal to delta multiplied by, I wrote theta here, 1 minus omega divided by omega dash. I am simply comparing this with the equation for the mean deviation, I mean angular dispersive power. Dispersive power is omega, isn't it? Now, see what has happened over here. See, the a is actually negative. It simply means that if this is my first prism, I will have to invert the second prism and keep it over here. So if I combine two prisms like this, depending on these values, if I select my second prism on the basis of a dash is equal to this value, then I can say that this will lead to deviation without dispersion. Fine. So these are the only two concepts that we are supposed to learn over here. Now, this kind of an approach you should be knowing so far as to crack any question in the exam. I don't expect complicated questions over here. That is why I did not discuss this in great detail, or I did not solve it in front of you in here, you can remember these two equations and the way we have derived these two equations. Whenever you say that you require something, you can add this to find the total value. Whenever you say that I don't want dispersion, I don't want deviation, then put that equal to 0. Find the angle of prism for the second prism. Find the a dash value, that is angle of prism of the second prism. And then put it in the other equation, that is whatever you want, that is actually added together, isn't it? So if it is dispersion without deviation, I don't want deviation here. I will put the net deviation is equal to 0. Then I will find the value of a dash from that. Then that a dash I will be putting it in the dispersion equation, right? And then I will compare with the equation for dispersive power, and I will get this kind of an equation as such. Okay, so at least remember the equations for there. And with that, we come to the end of the theory part for this. We'll discuss one or two questions out of that. Okay.